I'm watching Louis Theroux. He's probably my favorite journalist. He's talking to a guy called Randy James instead of James Randi. James Randi has books out about following and debunking televangelists. But yeah, these Freemasons are dangerous, and I will tell you why. Some reasons why. The two I work for, Pindic tempers as it is. So like, them looking at this will piss them off. But their moves, they're like, well, let's fuck with them from a distance. Tap his bank account. Fuck with his phone. Fuck this Facebook. Like, little ways of fucking with you that only you see. In the hopes that trying to consolidate and report the bulk of them will just make you come across as the lunatic. But you can see inside their heads, like, what they haven't confronted is godlessness. Truly haven't confronted it. So, and that has massive impact on how they operate. Because what they think will constitute a danger is meted out by the concepts in their religious belief. Hence, they are opposed to art. I could tell they already paid a price for it, conferences I had been to, because they would look and sound. I mean, I haven't done the number of drugs yet to look and sound the way that like Gary Kendall looks and sounds at staff conference. Singing Hey Jude to his wife. Because, you know, he needs to help her get out and about in town with a great big cop. And then Roger's dancing in a Roman toga to More Than a Feeling by Boston. His dance moves are like sidestep, sidestep, pretend I'm kneeling for the queen. Sidestep, sidestep, pretend I'm kneeling for the queen. Sidestep, sidestep, pretend I'm kneeling for the queen. And like, I mean, spookily, both my turntables stop reading CDs at the same time. How could that be? But, yeah, that was what I would see. And of the two of them, I don't think very much. If they intellectually confronted the non-existent, the prospect of the non-existence of supernatural beings, then they wouldn't come up with all these ideas that are wrong. And their process of trying to make a person admit something is also predetermined by like a ruling emperor, like, you know, point the finger at you, and after that it's the engineering of whatever they do. So that's the problem. It's just in their minds, but the citizenry isn't being told that, well, certain judgments have been made pertaining to your person, and the judge is religious, unqualified, in the field in which he's acted. A philanthropist and religious to the fucking shithouse. And so I think, you know, an Eminem CD is proof of dangerous intentions. Well, I believe that he believes at the same time that dangerous people have been made in such a way by his supernatural being. So by his own logic, it's his own deity's fault. But doesn't talk about that. You get to wear that. And so that's why I think what they're doing, removing things like the capacity for self-admittance, it's an intimidation technique. And leaving people to wonder how, why and how certain people will be picked for ward depository, Asians, ward depository Asians. They're feels like a bit like Queen of the Damned. You've already Googled and seen these logos of Freemasons. We are everywhere. Blah, blah, blah. And we'll come out and state what you believe in. You know? Psychic nutters have shown a little bit more decorum than you. Because, like, you're not allowing these people to join your religion. They're unworthy of that. And you happen to have this special insight into who's crazy as well. Wow. I would massively encourage Freemasons to read and consider A Passage by Nietzsche. Short story, Aphorism. Called The Child with the Mirror in the book Thus Spoke Zarathustra. And here we all are.